So hello guys, welcome back to our channel The Phoenix Pro. So in this video what we are going to see is how to create a multiplayer FPS game part 2. So in this video we will be creating our player movement, and if you haven't seen the previous video, check it out, links in the description down below. Okay, so first let's go to player motor and create a private vector 3 and call it velocity. Okay, so and we are going to default this to vector 3.0, and we are going to have some private reference to our rigid body. Or we create a start method here, like in the player controller start, and we will not need private, take that off. So here we can say rb equals get component and of type rigid body, and we can claim the component here, and then here we can create the method for setting our velocity variable. So basically what we want to do is we have to have this player controller control this variable, velocity variable, and we want to have a fixed object loop here that uses the variable to move the player. So the kind of method that we want to control this variable is simply going to be called move, okay, and it takes a vector 3. So public void move. Public void move, and simply call that as vector3_velocity, because we want to differentiate it, velocity, and don't forget here we have to put it in brackets. So guys, we want the velocity equals the velocity passed in here. So give tab, and I'm gonna write velocity equals _velocity. Yeah guys, now I've got it correct. I didn't understand why there was an error there. So it's fine right now. What I just did is I just erased move vector 3, and then I control X this things, and I gave move, and I rewrote the statement. It was working. So this here gets a movement vector. Then next we want to have some kind of fixed update looped. So before that, let's just go here velocity equals _velocity and finish that. And we want to have a fixed update loop here, so void fixed update and not private void. So yeah, that should do it. And then so we want to run this on a fixed time, so run. So we want to perform a movement which will actually do this movement. Perform movement based on velocity variable, and here, Okay, oh, I'm sorry, it's not I. And here we'll just create a void perform movement. And finish that. If and this is gonna check if velocity is not equal to vector 3 dot 0, so we actually want to move, we want to set, or we want to say that so we can call a method move position. So before that we'll go if velocity is not equal to vector 3 dot 0, then curly braces rb dot move base rb dot move position, and we want to call this on a rigid body, and this is a useful method. This takes in the position we want to move, and this is different from transform to translate, because this will actually stop the rigid body from moving there if it collides with something on the way. So this all the physics checks and the collision checks and all that, but this is much easier to control than the add force method. So in here we want to control add an transform dot right, transform dot right. Okay, instead of transform let's just add rigid body dot position plus velocity. Okay, and multiply this by time dot, I'm sorry, dot fixed delta time. So this will actually move our rigid body and our player to the position of our player plus the velocity vector. So on that, and let's go ahead and check this out in Unity. So here let's check if we can move now. Okay, we are able to move. Now next what we're gonna do is we're gonna move it here side to side and up and down. This have some kind of like rotation here. So here let's go here and create a rotation. Click calculate. Rotation as per. Okay. And we do this by first getting float underscore y rotation is equal to input dot get axis raw. So guys, we are gonna put input dot get axis raw, and the input we want to get is called mouse x. So brackets in quotations mouse and the capital X, okay, not small. And this will of course build as remember the space that I've given and the capital letters that I've given everywhere, just follow that. For another y-axis, so first we'll create a vector 3 here which is going to store our rotation. So vector 3 underscore rotation, so and it's going to be equal to new vector, and it's going to be 0, 0, y and 0. So let's just put that in here. So equals new factor 3. So in brackets again, 0f, comma, y rotation, comma, 0f. And we will multiply this by with some kind of sensitivity variable. So just like we have a speed like here, let's create a serialized field before that. Serialized field, and let's call it private float look sensitivity, and we'll equal that to 3f and finish that. So we'll simply multiply that down here. Look, so you'll notice here that I am using y rotation, which will be when we move our mouse to the left or to the right, and that means our x value from the mouse. So that's kind of there. Yeah, I know about it, but when we move our mouse on the x, we want to rotate around the y, and we are going to do this because y rotation is the only thing we want to affect our player. The rotation around the x-axis, meaning tilting up and down, well, that's what we want to affect our camera, because we don't want the entire speed to rotate up and down. That would mess up our movement. So when we do this, know that this is just for turning. So calculate rotation as a 3D vector. Here we are going to calculate that, and just say this. So we are going to apply rotation here. Just apply rotation motor dot rotate. So R is capital, and brackets underscore rotation. And let's go create that in the character motor. So here motor, and in here we are going to make a variable. We make it a private vector 3 rotation. And we need to do that vector 3.0, and yeah, I think that should do it. Then we want to make some kind of a method, so let's just copy and paste this. Okay. Public void rotate, yeah, and instead of underscore velocity, let's just set underscore rotation. Okay, so and we'll set that to rotation equals underscore rotation. Okay, it gets a rotational vector. rotational vector. Okay, now so here just let's give perform rotation here, rotation is that here, and then let's give perform rotation and void perform rotation. Okay, I guess that's good. Rotation, okay. And we simply want to say rb dot move rotation, so rb dot move, and whenever it comes to rotation there is some stop basically, because rotations in Unity goes through what is called a continuous system. If you continuous are basically just like vector 3s but with an imaginary component, and what this means I will explain it to you later. If you just comment down below, like, share and subscribe this video. So even rp dot add position move position, so rp dot rotation multiplied by quaternion dot u, and these are the angles that we know, that's x and y rotation, and that x n is simply in vector 3. So in here we can input our rotation, so rb dot rotation is a quaternion, and quaternion and Euler will take in a vector, so that makes sure that we don't have to understand what's going on, we can simply do this calculation, and that is really good. So let's save that now and get into Unity. Rotation, so guys I forgot to add rb dot move position, I have given it, so it's not position, it is rb dot rotation. So now let's control save, go back to Unity. This should work. So now yeah, okay, why isn't this not moving? Okay, it is moving. But when you play the game, right, it will move a lot. Just in the scene, it does not move here. So yeah, let's move on with the next section. Play a controller. X rotation, and we are going to call this camera rotation, and that with a capital R. Okay, delete all of these. So now what we do is we call this rotate camera, and call this camera rotation. So yeah, this should do it, and instead of apply rotation, let's give apply camera rotation. Okay, and this is again around the x axis, and we'll go to the player motor, and then let's create right. camera rotation. So rotation equals vector 3.0. Okay, yeah. So here down, let's create rotation. Rotation and probably this one probably for this item or scan. That's because we still didn't complete the sentence we got below. So come here, camera rotation is equal to camera underscore camera rotation. And what is this? Okay guys, I fixed the bug. The bug was just this is here, I didn't see. So we are gonna do the same here. We are gonna create a reference for our camera. Here, let's go. Let's create if cam is not equal to 9, meaning let's put a camera. Then we say that cam dot transform dot rotate. So here we don't need to do any rigid body calculation. We can simply rotate using the transform dot rotate, and we want to rotate using the camera rotation. So I've explained it to you. Just put the rotate ball and all the parentheses. Cam dot transform dot rotate. Okay, before you do that, just go to player and drag the camera in here so that you can move. So we can move here. Okay, mouse wipe. Okay guys, the reason why it's showing that error is because you are going to player controller, and if you are given small y, it's a really big problem. It is capital Y. I've done this mistakes more than 2-3 times. So clear, and now we should do it. Okay, it's moved too much. Okay, I'll just drag my scene here. Okay, yeah. What we gotta do is we just have to just give minus here in the player motor. Loading script assemblies. Click play. Okay. Click play. Yeah, now it is pretty smooth. Guys, don't forget to put the like button, share button, comment button, and subscribe button on new videos coming to me. So say, and among this gameplay, so yeah, that is pretty much it. If you like this video, please okay, like, share, comment and subscribe. And then don't worry, before that I just want to say that if you want more multiplayer FPS course, just comment down below, because I don't know if I'll be doing more videos like this. Maybe this will be the last one also. So suppose you want it, right, I can do it. So just comment down below that I want an FPS tutorial. So if you give more than 15 comments, not 15 also, just 10 comments, right, I will really appreciate it. I will make a multiplayer FPS game video. So the reason why I am doing it is because I am not having much time. Suppose if you comment, right, I'll definitely put more time and make another video. So let's go for 10 likes in this video. So signing out for now, peace out.